everyone, Steven here. Today, I want to show you how you can roast coffee at home. And that's actually a question that I get quite often now since I've started roasting coffee at home. And I just want to show you guys how you can do it yourself. Now, there's a lot of ways that you can roast coffee at home. You can spend a ton of money and buy a small home roaster, or you can actually roast coffee with things that you may or may not already have. So the first method that I want to show you out of this four-part YouTube series of home roasting, I'm picking the method that requires pretty much things that I know you're gonna have at home. And we'll run through those gear lists real quick, but just know that this method isn't quite the best. Out of the four, it's probably my least favorite, but I want to show you guys because it doesn't require you to really go out and buy anything else. I know you'll have what it takes to roast. All you'll need are the green beans. It just produces results that aren't super consistent. In one roast, you'll have some dark, you'll have some medium, and you'll have some light beans, and that's just the nature of this roast. But guys, without further ado, let's get into the roast, and let me show you guys what you will need to start roasting at home. So the gear list for this roasting method is pretty simple. You're actually only going to need a few items, and there's a few other items that are kind of nice to have, but they're not really necessary. So these are the items that are needed to start roasting your own coffee at home. You're going to need some kind of heat source, whether it's your kitchen stove or if you have a camp stove, you're going to need a heat source. You're also going to have a cast iron skillet. The next thing that you're going to need is a wooden spoon or a whisk. Once you're done roasting your coffee, you're going to need a way to cool it, so I prefer a metal colander for this. And finally, the last item you need when roasting at home is the green coffee beans. There are a few more items that I like to add to this list, but they're not necessary when roasting coffee at home. They just make it a whole lot easier. The first super handy item is some sort of infrared thermometer. That way, you know the temperature of your skillet and you know the temperature of your beans while you're roasting. The next thing that's nice to have is some sort of scale. That way, you know exactly how much coffee you're roasting, exactly how much coffee you get out of roasting, and if you bag your coffee, how much coffee is going into each bag. Another really nice thing to have is a small shop vac, because let's be honest, roasting coffee can get a little messy, especially when the chaff starts to fly everywhere. And the last thing on the list that's not necessary but super helpful is a journal. That way you can record all sorts of notes during the roasting process, like the temperature you put the beans in at, how many beans you actually roasted, how long it took to roast, when first crack was, all sorts of useful notes that the next time you roast, you can go back and review and try to repeat the same process over again. As you can see, to start roasting at home doesn't require a ton of things, and most of this is probably things you already have. To begin the roast, I want to weigh out my coffee. I'm going to weigh out 8 ounces of coffee. I'll do that by turning on my scale and tearing it out to zero, and then add my coffee till we hit the 8-ounce mark. Alright, so we have our 8 ounces of coffee. Let's start this roasting process. I like to bring the temperature of the skillet up to about 350 degrees. That way when I put the beans in, it doesn't begin to scorch immediately. Ideally, you want the temperature to be higher to roast, but I like to start at a lower temperature, and then I'll gradually raise the temperature as I begin to stir. Stirring is the key to this roasting method. You want to keep the beans going in the skillet. You don't want them to sit in one area too long because they will burn and they will scorch, and that's not going to taste good in the cup. So you just want to keep stirring. Periodically, I'll check the temperature of the beans just to make sure that the temperature is still climbing and just to make sure that we're on the right track. That's one of the reasons why I like to keep a journal, to try and keep each roast as consistent as possible, even though these are very inconsistent methods that we are using. Again, you just want to keep stirring, and you'll slowly notice the color of the beans change from a pale green to yellow to an orangish yellow, then to the brown that we want it to be. And that's just showing you that your beans are developing along in the roast. And I should say that even though while you are continually stirring,
you will still see some scorching happening on some of the beans. It's just the nature of this type of roasting method. It's not the best, and that's one of the reasons why I typically don't prefer it to the other ways that I roast coffee, but if it's what you have, it works. Once the beans get to a certain temperature, they'll begin to crack, and that's what we like to call first crack. Basically, it's the beans just letting off enough moisture and really starting to develop their flavor profile. We just want to keep stirring through this first crack, and it's going to be an audible crack. It's going to be pops. You may see a few beans jump around a little bit. No worries, just keep stirring. That's just letting you know that you are on the right track. At this point, you'll also see a lot of chaff start to come off and fill your skillet. Just keep mixing it up. We'll take care of all of that later. Now, once first crack begins to die down and the popping noise starts to get pretty quiet, that means you've fully gone through first crack and you are now able to take your beans off if you would like. You will probably have a lighter roast. You can also let it ride for a little bit longer to get a medium roast, but if you let them ride too long, you'll actually begin to enter into what we call second crack. The beans begin to crack again, and at this point, you're getting into the territory of a dark roast. Now, once you're ready to take your beans off, just pick it up, dump it in your colander, and begin to shake it around, stir it around, and this is just going to get all the chaff gone. After the beans are cool, I like to scoop around through, trying to find any beans that might not have been roasted thoroughly, or even some that I think are too burnt. Here you'll see the average color of the roasted coffee, and then you'll see a few beans that were under roasted. Now this is going to be normal in any roast, and honestly in any method. There's always going to be a few beans that just don't develop, and if you see them, I just pick them out and throw them away. It's not that big of a deal.
Alright guys, that's it. Pretty simple, pretty straightforward, right? Now we've got 6.5 ounces of coffee that I can't wait to brew. Guys, if you're going to do this at home, I've got two tips for you. First, buy 2 pounds of coffee. Take your first pound and learn from it. Experiment with it, try some different things out. And then hopefully, by the time you get to your second pound, you've kind of perfected some things and you've kind of got some things dialed in. You're now comfortable behind the skillet to know exactly how you want to roast your coffee. The other thing is when you're done roasting, set your coffee in a jar, put the lid on loosely or throw it in a bag, but don't zip it up, and let your coffee off gas for 24 to 48 hours. Now, trust me on this, this one's gonna be the hardest thing to do. You're gonna wanna brew it immediately, and you can, but honestly, for best results, I suggest you wait 24 to 48 hours so your coffee can off gas. All right, I hope you enjoyed our first home roasting episode. Guys, the next episode, I plan on showing you how to roast coffee using a Whirly Pop popcorn popper that you use on top of your stove. Guys, not only does that make amazing popcorn, but guys, you can roast some killer coffee with it too. So guys, I will see you then. Peace out.